Female canoe builders were not common in the mid-20th century, and May Minto charted her own course by building canoes with her brother for the family business in her small town of Minden, Ontario. During the Second World War, Minto had developed her skills in fabrication, working as a riveter on Lancaster heavy bombers out of Toronto for the war effort. Decades later, when the family's marine supply business eventually closed down, Minto continued her trade alone, supplying devoted summer camps in the area with beautiful wood canvas canoes. In the 1970s, when celebrated wildlife painter and environmentalist Robert Bateman was looking for a small wood canvas canoe to use at the family cottage, none other than one of May Minto's 13-foot canoes would do. Before gifting his canoe to the Canadian Canoe Museum, he mixed up his artist's paints to carefully touch up the scratches along the painted hull. For Bateman, the canoe provided an opportunity to get out on the water in solitude near the family cottage and to enjoy the natural environment that would serve as muse for a long and remarkable career. The Minto would even be featured in Bateman's work. The craftsmanship of May Minto and the remarkable artistic expression of Robert Bateman represent a long partnership between artists and canoes. Whether painted on rock faces, canvas, or even used in commercial advertisements, the canoe has certainly become iconic in Canada.
The Canadian Canoe Museum is home to the world's largest collection of canoes, kayaks, and paddled watercraft. But we don't just collect objects. The museum is a keeping place for the stories these vessels carry. Come for a visit and let us introduce you to some more of our favorites.